is your captain speaking. Captain Brendan Darcy? You know, on your enormous super yacht? You do remember you've got a yacht, right? Well, anyway, look, I don't mean to gripe, but things have been getting pretty hectic on board of late. Thought you might want to swing by, see what it's like to sit in the captain's seat. Seriously, hope to see you soon.
Hello.
Where to next, boss? Always got something on the boil out here.
Oh, Grog, you couldn't have stopped by at a better time, boss. Some bozos snuck on board, snatched the paperwork that classifies us as permanent residents of international waters, and made off on our jet skis. We don't get it back. We're going to get the biggest IRS bill of all time. So how about it? If you want to see what it's like to be me, go off and take them out. Last I saw the bastards, they were headed off towards the Vespucci Canals. I mean, I bet you thought me and the bartender had a pretty easy run of it out here on the ocean wave. But honestly, the crapola I have to deal with on a daily basis. I might as well be the captain of a giant floating magnet for every protester, pirate, eco-terrorist, rival 1%er and corrupt official in the state. Glad to see you walking a mile or two in my shoes. Seriously, mate. Some crew to pick up the skis. In the meantime, allow me to introduce you to a vital part of a captain's day-to-day work in the waters of Los Santos, enforcing the nautical pecking order. Those arseholes are all members of the yacht club down at Puerto del Sol. The naval code dictates we head over there and put their boats where they belong, at the bottom of the drink. Trust me, this is the fun part. Thank you. boss. Lesson 2 in the Brendan Darcy School of Seafaring. Taking advantage of opportunities at sea. Today's opportunity comes courtesy of the distress call we received a minute ago. There's a supply ship not far from here. Sounds like they're all in the drink. And as responsible seafarers, the first and only question we need to ask is, what's in it for us? Could be some profitable salvage if you're quick. Right, based on the coordinates from the distress call, you're in the right place. If we're lucky, the supplies might still be in one piece. You can hold your breath, right? Or, you know, use a rebreather. Whatever works.
But this would appear to be a teeny tiny hostage situation involving yours truly. And if that's not enough of a motivation for you, they've got the bartender too. Some Asian gentleman appeared to want compensation for a few yachts they claim we destroyed. Do you, know anything about that? Whatever, just come quickly. Oh, and come unarmed. These bastards mean it.
tut.
Did I ever tell you you're an excellent shot? The way your bullet undid my tie en route to that fella's head. Salvage job is gonna earn us a pretty penny. Silver lining, eh?
Okay, lesson three in Captain Darcy's Deepwater Diploma. Cultivating your associates. Go to the airport, I'll tell you all about it. We're doing a solid for the high and mighty of the Pacific Country Club. Apparently, an entirely legitimate business deal has turned more than a little acrimonious. And before you know it, the tennis coach is getting tipped off that their whole parking lot is about to go up in smoke. I promised we'd be there sooner than the fire department, and we'd bring our A game. The Coast Guard have those aerial firefighting planes down at the airport. It's time to get airborne and put out some flames. Once the country clubs go, the yachts are next. Believe me. Thank you. has a JATO system for quick takeoff. And then it's just a matter of getting over the fire and bombs away!
Thank you.
tactics go, this was an easy one. Last Tuesday, we got boxed in by a fleet of climate activists on sailing skiffs. Wasn't pretty, and I'm not just talking about armpit hair. Good to see you back. Today's assignment is a real doozy. Sitting in the captain's chair isn't all about putting out fires, you know. Sometimes you need to go on the offensive to stay ahead of the next wave. With that in mind, head to the frigid warehouse in Cypress Flats. You'd never guess who's using it to store some volatile, temperature-sensitive product. Those money launderers who had the nerve to kidnap me. I figure, since we're making enemies in that direction already, we might as well make a few bucks, right? Step one, take out their aircon, shut them down. Step two, take whatever they've already loaded up for transport and get it to the buyer on their behalf. Step three, back to the yacht for a frosty one of our own. Sound like a plan? Let's do it. Step one yet? Step two's a calling. Get in the truck. I'll ping you a GPS for the buyer. Fair warning, these fellas are probably gonna want it back, and they're not very polite people. recently been fitted out with heavy ordnance? I don't think it's them. Our anti-aircraft systems are all down, so you're our first and last line of defense. I'm getting down to the engine room. Fuzz, it's been... let's say we put this rivalry to bed. The head honcho of that money laundering outfit we've been scrapping with is on some mega secure yacht not far from here. And I found us a sub we can use to dip under his defenses. Head over there and get it. We're going down under, so to speak.
Well, boss, I'd say your captain's training is complete. Top marks, best in class. And to mark your graduation from the Brendan Darcy Naval Academy, I've left a little something for you in your wardrobe. Trust me, you might as well throw away all that other stuff you wear. Now, life out here being what it is, I'll still have the occasional bit of business to do in future. So don't be a stranger.